We have heard that we don't talk about immigration enough, which we know isn't true. But just in case anyone still believes that, Diane's now on her third speech. I won't spend too much time introducing Diane, as so much is known about her already. For example, we all know that in 1987 she made history by becoming the first black woman elected to British Parliament. But something some do not know is that Diane's maiden speech, which she made 31 years ago now, was on an immigration bill. And since that time, she has been consistent in her call for a fairer immigration system in Britain, something which she hopes to achieve in a coalition Labour government. Just to recap, in the first speech in March this year, Diane explained Labour's values as they would apply to immigration policy. And in the second speech in May, she dealt with Labour's approach to ending the hostile environment and addressing the Windrush scandal. Today, Diane will be outlining how Labour's new immigration policy is ready for the next Labour government and fit for a post-Brexit Britain, putting fairness, equality, jobs and prosperity first. So without further ado, I give you the Shadow Home Secretary, Diane Abbott.
I know that some of you have come from as far as Hackney, and I'd like to give them a special welcome. As you've heard, this is the third in the series of speeches that I'm giving on immigration. Immigration is central to our public political debate, and it's something, as you've just heard, that I made my very first speech on in Parliament. But just to recap on the first two speeches, in the first speech, I dealt with Labour's value as they apply to immigration. And I'm very clear that our immigration policies should be values-based. And I pledge to uphold the right to family life. For all of those entitled to be here, there will be no deportations of their family members, no exclusions of their family members, and no minimum income requirement to bring their family members in. Some of you will have seen the television pictures of Mexican children held in cages at the US-Mexican border. That is where paying no attention to the family and people's right to family union takes you. Should be a lesson to us where that takes you, and we are pledged to upholding the Queen's phrase.